Hi guys, welcome to the channel. Today I have a very interesting video for you, so stick around to the end of this video. And if you like it, give it a like and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more effective remedies. So without further ado, let us get straight to today's video. So today's video is a highly requested one and it's about how to make rice water. Now, rice water is so good for the hair as well as the skin. But in today's video, I'm specifically going to be focusing on the hair part. And it's very good for the hair because it has a lot of vitamins and minerals. And it helps the hair to grow so fast. It leaves your hair very strong and looking very healthy. So if you have bald patches or maybe your hair doesn't grow too well, then rice water is something that you should try out. Also for the skin, it acts as a natural toner. So if you want an evenly toned skin, then you should definitely try out the rice water. Now I have three ways to make the rice water. In the first method, you just need to take a cup of rice, wash it well, and then add 1 cup of water to it. But your measurements are going to depend on how much rice water you need. So take your rice, this is about a cup of rice. I'm gonna wash it up to remove any impurities or any chemicals, and then I'm going to add 1 cup of water to it. Now my rice is clean, so I'll just add a cup of water. Stir it a bit to mix it up. Then leave it for about 15 to 20 minutes. Now once you shampoo your hair, you're going to use this water to rinse it off. But then you're going to leave it for 15 minutes to 1 hour, depending on how much time you have. But make sure when you're rinsing it, you massage your scalp very well, because this will help to stimulate the scalp and it's also going to increase the blood circulation on your scalp. Now you're going to leave it for about 30 minutes to 1 hour, depending on how much time you have. And then you're going to now rinse it well with clean water. And so that's our first method. Do it regularly and you're going to see good results on your hair. Now our second method is almost similar, but this time we're boiling the rice to get the rice water. So just take your cup of rice, wash it very well, and then put it in your pan. Then you're going to put it on low heat for about 10 to 15 minutes. So it works almost the same. Once you shampoo your hair, rinse it off with the rice water, and then make sure you massage your scalp well. This will help with stimulating the scalp and increasing the circulation of blood on your scalp. And then after you leave it for about 15 minutes to 1 hour, then you can rinse it off with clean water. And that's about it. Our last method, which is the most effective way of making your rice water, is by fermenting it. And to achieve this, you need to leave your rice for about 24 hours for it to ferment. So what you do, you just take your cup of rice. Wash your rice very well to remove any impurities or chemicals, and then add a cup of water to it. Now you need to cover this rice. If you have an airtight container, the better, but you can also use a cling film to cover it up. So cover it up like this, tightly, for 24 hours. After 24 hours, it will have changed the color and it's going to look a bit thicker and more white. And that way we'll have gotten all the nutrients from the rice. Now this is perfect. This is the perfect way to do it. And it works perfectly for the hair. Now you'll notice that it has a bit of a sour smell. And that just tells you it has fermented. So strain out the water and then rinse your hair using the water after you shampoo. Now give it a good massage. And this will help stimulate the scalp as well as increase the blood circulation. Now in case you cannot stand the smell of the fermented rice, you can use a few drops of peppermint essential oil. This will help curb the smell, but also peppermint oil is very good for the hair. But that's a story for another day. So you can also use any other essential oil that you like just to prevent that smell. And this way you can store it in the fridge for about a week and this will prevent it from fermenting further. That's it for this video, guys. Please try it out and leave me a comment on the comment section below and I'll be glad to hear from you. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and I'll see you on the next video. Thank you for watching and bye.